squad will be discussed later.
We're going to be centering our discussion around police squad, currently being given a run on BBC Two on Thursday nights at 9 o'clock.
Sergeant, take her away and book her.
Sergeant, take her away. Sergeant, book her.
Well, Jack, was that funny?
Well, to me, I felt it actually relied too heavily on jokes, really. I just, you know, find ultimately that, strangely, that jokes aren't necessarily the best vehicle for comedy. You know, no, I think that...
I don't think that's right, John. I mean, even Aristophanes used jokes.
Well, yeah, but he didn't call them jokes.
Yeah, well, what did he call them?
Well, I don't know what's Greek for jokes.
yeah, Jack, I mean, if jokes aren't funny, then what is?
Well, I mean, obviously these things are personal, but to me, it's strange, but I mean, really, the only thing I find myself laughing out loud at these days is Pavements and Dickie Davis.
Right. Now, you see, what interests me is we watched the whole of that police squad show and we counted 93 jokes. Now, Henri Bergson, in his book on comedy, Le Rire, says there are only 7 jokes.
No, I think Bergson meant type of joke, rather than...
Right. Yeah. So what are the 7 types of joke?
Oh, right. Yeah, well, there's satire, slapstick, hyperbole, funny, extremely funny, mildly diverting, and Pavements and Dickie Davis.
That's 8.
Well, at least we've proved Bergson wrong, haven't we?
Nick Newman, you're a comedy writer. You've been listening to all of this. Could you get me a glass of water, please?
Yes, of course.
Nick. Is that way? Thanks. Professor Mallinson.
That's right.
Good.
I've got the sandwiches here.
All right, Eddie, you went to the movies. Now, what did you see?
I told you, I don't remember.
Who had the egg salad?
I don't remember.
Somebody ordered it.
You can't expect us to buy that.
But I already paid for it.
Why don't you give a guy a break?
Thanks a lot.
What's the charge, huh?
$4.58.
What are you trying to do, insult us?
Okay, $3.50.
I find it interesting that they chose the name Frank Drebin. I mean, do you think that's got any significance, Professor?
Mm. Possibly.
Murray.
Yeah, I think it is. I think it is significant. Yeah, Frank Drebin. Frank obviously is forthright, disingenuous.
Yeah, well,
and Drebin is in fact a non-fired clay pot from Central Asia, which I think is very significant.
Yeah, but I think it's simplistic. I mean, still.
Well, it's hard.
Well, no, I mean, just it's for me. I mean, just personally speaking, for me, the interesting thing is that Drebin backwards is Nebert, which you know is which becomes very easily Nebuchadnezzar. The famous Egyptian centre half.
How exactly does the famous Egyptian centre half tie in with police squad?
Exactly. Masters of the absurd.
Sally Decker. Sally Decker, that name rings a bell. No, I can't place it. Look, I'm telling you, I don't know her. All right, I know her. She was a patient of mine. Her lower left quadrant was all messed up, but so what? Okay, look, she's a good looking dame. We went out and had a laughs, a couple of drinks, but that's the whole story. Look, I don't need trouble. I'll cooperate. My God, you're an animal.
I am not an animal. I am a silver zoo.
Police Commissioner, what did you make of all that?
Rubbish.
Thanks, Nick.
Load of old nonsense, the whole lot of it. I mean, I was very, very disappointed. I mean, It's nothing like the real thing. The accents were, frankly, incredible. So wide of the mark. I mean, some of them, to me, sounded American, to be honest, you know. I mean, uniforms? Yeah. Nowhere near it. Look at them. I mean, haven't they heard of police canteens?
Thank you, Police Commissioner. That was very illuminating.
Mm.
Clip.
Oh, poor Ralph. And what about my daughter? What am I going to tell her?
Tell her he went on a long trip.
Oh, wait a minute. How about a big monster came and took him to Daddy Heaven?
Oh.
Nah.
What about this? He threw himself on a grenade and saved a battalion. Yeah, that's it.
No, wait a minute. He was killed by left-wing insurgents from Paraguay. Now, Bolivia.
I got it. He was traded to the Cubs for Reggie Jackson.
Can I just say, Murray, that was actually the single most interesting thing I have heard in a very long time. Thank you.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah, I mean, the point I was trying to make, you know, if Jack here would let me go over an edge.
Funny, actually, Murray, you mentioning the absurd there, because...
I didn't mention the absurd.
Yes, but you were going to, I could sense. Because it reminds me of the very famous story of Grok, the French clown, and I think in any discussion on comedy, this one is always important to tell. It's a very relevant story. I think it's a key story in many ways. And the story is that Grok, the clown, he goes to the doctor, and he says to the doctor, "Doctor, can you help me? I'm very depressed." To which the doctor replies, "I'm not surprised, mate. I saw your show last night, and I'd be depressed."
I don't think that's the story, actually.
No, it's not the complete, quite right. I mean, I'm made up the second.
Yeah, well, thank you very much for that, Annick. Right, now I think
we
have to move.
If you want to know the actual story, actually, the actual story, Grok went to see his doctor, right, and said, "Can you help me? I'm depressed." Yeah. And his doctor said, "Well, can I suggest you go and see Grok?"
Oh, that's it.
That'll cheer you up. That'll cheer you up. To which Grok replied...
Listen to this.
They will listen. Grok replied, "I can't. I'm sold out."
No, surely the story is that Grok is feeling depressed. So he goes up to a doctor and says, "I'd like to see a doctor." And the doctor replies, "But I am a doctor." I'll get some more water.
Will it be?
Screwdriver.
Anything to drink?
No, thank you.
No, that's very funny. that's very funny. Very funny.
Sorry, that really is the first time I've heard in a very long time.
Very funny.
Where did you hear that?
Professor, we haven't really heard much from you.
That's right. Well, I think it's interesting that Drebin spelt backwards is Nebern. And also that in his book entitled on the front cover and the spine, Bergson said some things about comedy. He wrote these things down on a piece of paper with a pen, then typewriter. I don't think he used a word processor. As I say, he wrote these things down, found himself a publisher, and had the book sold in many major bookstores. And I think Roland Barthes did the same thing, but on a different subject.
Yeah, well, it'll probably be about half an hour, Sarge. Yeah, if you want to be accurate, yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah, I think it's going for it. Oh, do you think so? Well, that's very kind of you. Yeah, well, it's all right. Yes, I think so. Well, anyway, kindest regards to the late shift lads. See you soon. Right, yeah. And, well, I always thought Zed cars was very funny myself, yes. And
And that bloke, what's the one with the curly hair? He used to be a magpie.
Yeah, fantastically illuminating, Commissioner, once again. I just like to say at this point that I think it's quite astonishing that the work of Abrahams and Zucker's, who after all bought us Airplane, and Naked Gun, their work's never really successfully transferred to the small screen.
I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah, Professor?
Delighted you brought it up. I really am very, very, very pleased indeed. So pleased that I'm just going to make my way home to do a spot of celebrating. And thanks again for bringing it up.
I'm sorry, they were out of water, so I rustled up some sandwiches. There's some tuna and cheese and pickle and shrimp.
Shrimp
sauce.
Oh, really? Thanks.
Right, well, perhaps to conclude, let's just say comedy is subjective.
Okay.
Comedy is subjective.
And it's just time now for a final word from everyone, but you'll have to keep it brief. Not quite that brief.
Good night.
Right. Well, I think you can see yourselves out.
We've got the bolivons.
Morwenna Banks and the team from Channel 4's Absolutely.